Donald Trump guilty. That is the verdict. 12 jurors found against the former US president on all counts in his criminal hush money trial.
It makes him the first ex-president to ever be convicted of a felony as he continues his campaign to return to the White House. Let's bring in former White House spokesperson Pete Seat once again. Good morning to you, Pete. Donald Trump now a convicted felon. What about that?
Well, we didn't expect this when we last met a few hours ago, and especially did not expect that it would be on all 34 counts. I was just thinking about this a moment ago, and if I went to dinner with 11 of my friends to get pizza, I don't think all 12 of us could agree on the toppings we should get. And yet you have 12 strangers who did not know each other 6 weeks ago, all came to a unanimous agreement on all 34 counts. And that is incredible in this political environment that we live in.
Yeah, so the big question now is, what will this do for his support? There is talk that this was kind of trivial. And for a lot of people, it was a bit of a paper trail issue, because it's not illegal to pay a hush money to this woman. It was the way he did it. So how will it affect him, do you think?
Well, you look at the polling, whether you support or don't support Donald Trump determine whether you thought he was guilty or not guilty going into this trial and throughout this trial. But we're already seeing a circling of the wagons from Republicans, senators, members of the U.S. House of Representatives, mayors, candidates for office, you name it, are all blasting out statements supporting former President Trump. Just a few minutes after the verdict came out, his campaign sent an email in which he says, and I have it pulled up on my phone, "I am a political prisoner." And then a few sentences later, asks 10 million, quote, patriots to contribute to his campaign today. And as you mentioned earlier, the WinRed website, which is the site that a lot of Republican candidates use, actually went down. The volume of requests was so high that the server shut down. It's now working. They're now taking donations. But you're going to see a spike in support for the former president as a result of this.
Unbelievable. We just saw Donald Trump outside Trump Tower there. It sounded all very positive. Obviously, his supporters out the front of the building behind him, whether that's an indication, who knows. In terms of sentencing, the date has been set for July 11. Is that significant? And also, too, what does that mean going forward? Will he appeal? What does it mean for the campaign?
It's a significant day, July 11th, because it's 4 days prior to the Republican National Convention, where he is officially nominated as the Republican nominee for President of the United States. So you can imagine that this entire trial, the sentencing, is going to be a focal point and a message that is delivered likely every night of that 4-day convention. He will appeal. I'm no lawyer, so I don't know exactly how that plays out, but he is very skilled at working the judicial system to his advantage when it comes to timing and delaying ultimate accountability in these cases. So it's possible, unless it's expedited, that an appeal could drag out until the end of the year.
Yeah, OK, so that's past the election, November 5. Interesting. Pete Seat, we thank you very much for your expertise this morning.